Hi YouTube and welcome to another video from Richco Photo. This is the second part of me driving out of London. I wasn't going to post this bit, but after watching it through again, there are some interesting bits to point out on the journey, and I will speed things up from time to time when it gets a bit boring. As you can see, we're coming right out of the centre of London now, out the back of Mayfair and beyond, and heading west out of London. A lot of these houses on the left here, some of them are solicitor offices and, you know, other like recruitment agencies and things like that. And over on the right, some residential buildings and flats as well. And the sun gets in because, again, it's the day's coming to a close, so the sun is in the way a little bit from time to time. So apologies for that. But as you can see, the cars are, it's a three-lane carriageway. We just went through past a BMW agent there on the left-hand side. And it's interesting that the lights on that car is flickering. I'm shooting at 48 frames a second at 1080p, and they're flickering away. Must be something to do with the LEDs in the back of it. And there's a London cab to the right. It's an icon of London these days, and has been, I guess, for many, many years. So the reason for posting this video, some people seem to really enjoy it. I had a few negative comments about it, but, you know, they were easily deleted and blocked and got rid of those. And now we're coming up right into the sun now with all some advertising hoardings and some new screens that they've put up over time on the right-hand side. And these billboards now are all electronic advertising. That's advertising Tekken 3. I think that's an office block to the left there is empty at this point. I'm not sure what they're doing in there. And we're running along the A4 west out of London, as I said just a minute ago. But really what it does, it gives you an opportunity just to see the buildings and the vehicles, the cars and the pubs, like that pub down on the left, and some of the smaller shops that are around. And if you can imagine how these buildings were in Victoria times, look how long that building is. It's just one complete building with separate houses in each one. And it just seems to go on and on and on and curves around the same way as the road does. So I'm wondering whether the road was there before the houses or the houses were before the road. Who knows? Chicken and egg. And as we are heading out of London, you don't really get to see many high-rise buildings. We've got one there on the right-hand side. I think they're flats. Lots of restoration work going on these houses. And it's quite interesting because sometimes you get old and sometimes you get new. And I think on the left here, they're starting to have a new project. New offices are going up. There used to be a big building there, but I can't remember what it was. But there you go. And this is an interesting building coming up on the left-hand side. And I think it's just general office space. I don't think it's anything. They've got something like this on the M5 down in Bristol, where it is an RAC building that overlooks all the motorway and traffic control and everything. So I'm wondering what that is. I just think it is a standard building with offices in it. And this road is sort of, I guess, 50, 60 feet in the air on stilts right through these buildings. And then you get all these modern buildings, and all of a sudden you get a church right in the middle of all of it. And then an old building on the left-hand side. A couple of more billboards advertising. Now, I'm used to seeing this in the centre of London, and, you know, the times I've been to America, around Florida and places like that, you get to see lots of flashing billboards and lights, and which is quite nice. And here we go, we're coming back down to ground level again. Lots of residential flats on the right-hand side. And that is a Tesco's delivery van there, for those people that don't know. You can order all your groceries online and they will deliver it to your house now. No need to go to the shops if you don't want to. And as you can see, the further we get out of London, the traffic tends to get reduced. So I'm going to speed this bit up in a second and go through. There's another BP garage there. I delivered there when I used to work for BP many years ago. And I'm going to play a little bit of music so you can just watch the sort of scenery around you. This is the last bit of road out of London as we head towards the M4 and west towards Reading, and that would take you down to the West Country, down towards Devon and Cornwall, probably 120 miles away, 130 miles away from where we are. And these are the large and the last big signs as we leave London. And again, we're on the elevated section. It's a new building being built on the left. And the further you get out of London now, the more the building starts to come up. I think they're starting to spread out quite a lot now. So London's pretty well chock-a-block. There's a South Store building there that's quite nice. You can see right in there when you're driving past in the car. And you can see they're all glass buildings. Now we're still heading towards the M4, and the sun does go behind those buildings in a minute, on and off. The RSI, I don't know what that building is. They're residential flats that you can see in the distance there on the left-hand side, the one the sun's disappearing behind every so often. And although this is three lanes now down to two, it's still only 40 miles an hour along here. And I think this is the last set of buildings. So that's an older building there. And then you've got Porsche and Mercedes to the right hand side. They've got some really cool, that's Audi there as well, a nice Audi building. Had a big bow round it for Christmas. And you can see, look, they're starting to build further out of London now through this elevated section. It's the only space that's left. Some really interesting buildings being built, some really nice looking buildings too. So I'm going to leave this now, just let the sun set, and as you drive off into it, I hope you enjoyed these two videos. Thanks for watching, please subscribe and enjoy the rest of the video. You have a great day.